that I'm always held back, and these obstacles do not rest for me. And what did I do to deserve my life dressed in these negative thoughts? And like anchors, they drag my body down. I am trying. The snow is icy. Where did my lungs go, filled up with the words they spew again and again? Their thoughts are poisonous and leeching. I look away. I am crushed by the weight of the world. I do not know how to push aside the things that are heavy. I do not know how to unshare this burden. The storms collapse within me. Be better. Don't be stupid. You aren't good enough, they say. We don't need you.
Stop!
Nothing. You're nothing. There is a bridge, they say. It is the walkway to another place. My steps fall heavy. Breathe. Breathe. I am here. I see it over there. The glowing warmth. It is the blanket of a long day's rest. It is the next day. The one that seems to never come. The gift. The thing we all hold so deeply. The vibrancy. The end of darker days. I am here. And I go. I feel my heart sinking upwards and lifted towards the greater cause. The greater being that I so desperately want. This path will take me there. This place of an unhealthy being will bring me towards it, towards that place. I can feel it. I can touch the light that melts towards the endless good. And there, I am freed.
Need to tell our story and enjoy our lives together, to hand out the storm in colder weather, caring for everyone in your life, working towards the end goal, making the world a better place for every soul. We need to tell our story and enjoy our lives together, to hand out the storm in colder weather, caring for everyone in your life, working towards the end goal, making the world a better place for every soul.
See, the point of the song wasn't to sound cynical. The last two verses were to emphasize the pinnacle, the most pure and wholesome community, the one that creates the strongest type of unity, a feeling deeper than the ocean. So let me tell you how to start the motion. Find opportunities for ongoing connection, and your life will point in a whole new direction. In this community, you are always welcome. Try it out, and you'll love the outcome. If you try, you can see how great the world can be through deepening community.
And when each and every human makes acceptance a priority, that's when common people harmonize with their authority. That's when conflicts are resolved by using peaceful methods. People caring, equal sharing, learning useful lessons, joining and expressing thoughts like sisters and like brothers, taking care of yourself and then taking care of others. It starts with getting past our differences and then embracing every walk of life, gay, straight, black, white, or Asian. We start it small and let it grow and exercise our patience, cause it will spark and slowly come to each and every nation. When we are cold and we're reserved, our unity is weakened, but through compassion and respect, community is deepened.
We need to tell a story, and enjoy our lives together, to hinder the storm and colder weather. Caring for everyone, caring in your life, working towards the end goal, making the world a better place for every soul.
Everyone in your life working towards
the end goal. Making the world a better place for every soul.
Thank you. 7:30. Wake up. Get showered. Start getting ready. Need a shirt. Belt. Tie. Go downstairs, get breakfast, read the paper, before grabbing the keys on the way out. Rinse and repeat. 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 Wait. Realization. Next day. Wake up at 7. More time to get ready. More time to get ready means trying something new. Trying something new means no routine. No routine means adventure. Because when nothing is planned, anything can happen.
Send him in.
That'll be all today. So tell me what happened.
I already told you on the phone he must have been tipped off. He wasn't there when I got there.
That doesn't make any sense. I'm disappointed. This should have been an easy mission. Anyways, here's a new phone. I'll call you on this in a couple of days. Keep it handy. And don't mess this one up. We found the guy. We'll be sending the address shortly.
Done, sir.
hot. It's like an oven in here.
What's that smell?
Oh wait, that's just me.
So what are the facts again?
Both events conflict.
We have to come to a decision.
We're running out of time.
I've got to go to the bathroom.
What's the alibi?
A coordinated sleepover. Can we review the information one more time?
No, we have to vote again.
It's that simple, ladies.
What about motive?
That's easy. It's their last time together.
Yeah, so strike while the iron is hot. An opportunity like this comes once in a lifetime.
Seriously, this stuff happens all the time. We just need to decide on how we feel and come to a decision.
This is
why I don't go to girl guides anymore.
I really have to go to the bathroom.
No one is leaving until we are all in agreement.
This is taking forever.
I'm hungry.
That's it. Let's get focused.
Here, think very carefully before you write your answer.
This decision carries a lot of weight.
Write clearly this time.
And no emoticons or doodles.
It was one time.
Girls, no discussion.
Your vote must be private.
I really, really have to go to the bathroom.
Well, the faster we get this done, the quicker you can go.
Okay, hand in your votes. Okay, so the results are as follows.
We have 10-4
and 1-4.
Seriously?
What? Whose vote was that?
You can't ask that. It's supposed to be ambidextrous.
You mean unanimous.
It's anonymous.
That's what I said.
So does this mean we're done?
Woohoo.
Sit down. It has to be unanimous.
Look, we just have to vote again.
We have 8-4
and 3-4.
Oh, come on.
Who changed their vote?
You can't ask that.
I knew I should have showered this morning.
I knew this was a bad idea.
Yep, a big mistake.
Didn't you have to go to the bathroom?
That was the mistake I was talking about.
Oh, you!
This wasn't supposed to be this hard.
Decide. I'm afraid it looks like both the Justin Bieber and One Direction concerts are sold out.
March 31st, 2017. I always tried to help people who look like they need it. I never thought my life was that bad. We have never really had as much as other people did. Yet we got by most of the time. My father left when I was a little boy. And it broke my mom's heart. She got remarried pretty quickly, but he only made things worse. My mom does her best. But raising a son can be a handful by yourself, I guess. This new guy made it pretty hard to go home. My mom started to seem more and more afraid. It made my life seem scary. It was like there was this dark cloud looming over my head. That seemed like it would never go away. We were never religious. Yet, I would always pray that things would get better, but there was nothing I could do. It was kind of out of my control.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm.